Game two of the season for the Manchester Hornets girls. Head coach, Lauren DeBoy. Head coach of the Ipswich team, Jim Profoot. And we're almost ready for some basketball. Manchester comes into this game with the 1-0 record. They won on opening night. They beat Georgetown. All right, here come the starting lineups, and we're just about ready to tip this game off. Isabella Pomeroy, that's center. Deidre O'Flynn from Ipswich, and Ipswich controls the opening tip-off, and we're underway. So Ipswich gets the first possession, number 32 in possession. Kelsey Daly passes it over to number 40, and offensive foul. Deidre O'Flynn, number 40, she drove the lane, but she committed an offensive foul. And the Manchester turns the ball over on their first possession. So Ipswich goes number 3, way off. Rebound, Hornets. And they turn it over again. So Manchester, their first two possessions, turn the ball over.
Chloe's got ball.
So Ipswich on the offense. They get it underneath. They come out with it, stolen by the Hornets. And so Manchester takes control. They get it in the middle. And ball goes out of bounds, white ball. So the first minute or so of this game, a little bit sloppy. No scoring. Manchester will inbound it. They get it out. Three-pointer, no good. Rebound, Tigers. So here comes Ipswich. Number 12, Chloe Rogers has the ball. She passes it off to number 32, Kesley Daly. Daly, looking to set the offense. She passes it over. Back over to Daly. Daly took a shot up and is no good. And Manchester with the rebound, we get a foul. Foul on Ipswich. Foul on number 12. For Ipswich. Chloe Rogers, here comes Manchester. To get the ball up high. Three-pointer, number 24, no good. Rebound Ipswich. That three-point shot was taken by Sarah Robinson. And we have a foul on Manchester. Foul was on Sarah Robinson, that's her first. So here come the Ipswich Tigers. And the foul. Kelsey Daly drove to the lane for Ipswich. And Sarah Robinson gets fouled again, but that was in the act of shooting, so Daly will go to the line and shoot too. Shot is up, and it's good. So there's the first point of the game. Number 32, Kesley. Kelsey Daly of Ipswich. She'll get another one. Shot is good. Okay, so Ipswich leads it 2-0. Manchester will inbound it. Bridget Kernan. Over to O'Connell. Caitlin O'Connell. O'Connell has it. And it's another turnover for Manchester. So here come the Tigers. Shot, no good. Rebound Ipswich. So Daly with it. She drives the lane, throws it up. No good, but she gets fouled again. Foul is on number three on Manchester, Courtney Hawley. That's her first. Daly throws it up. It's good. So we have a timeout. With the score, Ipswich 3, Manchester nothing. We'll be back in a few minutes.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
At Ben's Wallpaper and Paint, you will experience a level of service you thought no longer existed. We're proud to deliver the kind of specialized attention that you thought no longer existed and simply won't find in larger chain stores. Whether from our full line of Benjamin Moore paint or custom window treatments, you will find what you need at Ben's Wallpaper and Paint at 6th Railroad Avenue here in Gloucester. Community is the key. That's why we support KPN Television, so they can deliver valuable, local, community-based news, sports, and information about KPN, which is so important to all of us.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPN TV. You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
Cape Ann Auto Body and Service Center has served Cape Ann families since 1955. We learned long ago that the best way to keep our customers is to provide skilled and friendly services at reasonable prices. Unlike large or chain repair businesses, each of our customers is a very important part of our business.
Personal is what makes Cape Ann Television so valuable to our community. That's why we support Cape Ann Television, so that they can deliver valuable community-based news, sports, and information about Cape Ann, which is so important to us all.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support Cape Ann TV.
Everybody, welcome back. 3-0 Ipswich. Kelsey Daly, she has all the points so far in this game. And she is at the line now, taking the second shot of a foul. Different two foul shots. I'm Phil Nicastro and Tim Evans on the camera tonight. Thank you, Tim. Daly at the line. Shot is up. It is no good. In and out. So Ipswich in the 3-0 lead. Manchester are off to a slow start. But the Hornets are on the offense right now. They're swinging around. They get it underneath. Nice play. Number 10, Isabella Pomeroy. Puts Manchester on the board. Tigers go back on offense, the Ipswich Tigers. They get it up high. Daly again. They swing it around. 3-2 Ipswich, 3-pointer, no good. Rebound, Ipswich. No, Manchester. And we get a foul. On number two for Ipswich, Tatum Galuski. And here come the Hornets, looking to take their first lead. They get it in the middle, and it's off of Ipswich. Ball goes out of bounds. Manchester Essex maintains possession. With 4:20 left, first quarter, 3-2 Ipswich. Manchester on the offense. They get it into Pomeroy, nice. Isabella Pomeroy, number 10, gives Manchester a 4-3 lead with about 4:05 remaining in the first quarter. And a turnover. But Ipswich comes back up with it. Three-pointer, no good. And we have a substitution coming in. Number four for Manchester comes in, Grace Brennan. Courtney Hawley comes out. So Ipswich will go back on the offense. They trail it by 1-4-3. Daly throws it up. No good again. Rebound. Ipswich. And got a 3-second violation on Ipswich. So Manchester will go back on the offense. They bring the ball to the floor and get a foul. Foul on Ipswich, number 12, Chloe Rogers. Non-shooting foul. So Manchester will inbound it. Pomeroy with it, number 10. Three-pointer from number 12. Melanie Carter, she missed it. And traveling. Ipswich got the rebound, but they traveled. Tatum Galuski traveled. So Manchester will maintain the possession. Three-pointer. No good. Rebound. Manchester. And it's up and it's good. Melanie Carter with a good rebound underneath. Manchester with a 6-3 lead. 3:05 left in the first quarter. And Ipswich has possession. And traveling. Deidre O'Flynn from Ipswich traveled. So Manchester will inbound it. Nice passing. They bring the ball up the floor. And we get another foul. Chloe Rogers again with another foul. So Manchester will inbound from half court. Pomeroy with it. And it's a, no, Manchester gets, oh, we got a foul. Cassidy King of Ipswich with the foul. Again, these are all non-shooting fouls. So Manchester on the offense. They get it down low to Pomeroy. She brings it back up high to number 23. And no good on the shot. Pomeroy with a strong rebound underneath again. And turnover by Manchester. Here comes Daly of Ipswich. Kelsey Daly, number 32 of Ipswich, the point guard. She's leading the offense. She drives in the lane, nice pass, but she can't control it. And here come the Hornets. They get it up high. They swing it around. Good ball movement. They get it down low. And we get a foul. Cassidy King with another foul, Ipswich. So right now, Ipswich with 16 fouls. They're going to be over the limit soon. Manchester will inbound it. They get it in, three-point attempt. Good. Number 23, Caitlin O'Connell. And the Hornets have a 9-3 lead. So the Ipswich Tigers are on the offense. And what do we got, a foul? No. Foul away from the ball on Ipswich, number 15, Kate Pfeiffer's. Here come the Hornets again. They get it up high. Good pass in. Underneath, no good. Rebound, Hornets. Shot is up, it's no good. And here comes Ipswich. Manchester with a 6-point lead. We approach 1 minute left in the first quarter. Daly passes it off. They get it up high. And double dribble. Kate Pfeiffer's again. Double dribble, so Manchester goes back on the offense. And Manchester again swinging the ball around nicely. They get it to the side court. Shot, no good. That was a baseline shot. Manchester, Ipswich with the rebound. Here comes the, here come the Tigers. Daly with it. She passes it off. Ball is up on the perimeter. Shot, no good. Rebound, Hornets. Shot is up, no good. Rebound, Tigers. We got a foul on Grace Brennan of Manchester. That's the fourth team foul for the Hornets. We only got 6 seconds left in the first quarter. So Ipswich will inbound. They're looking for the last shot. Shot is up. No good. Underneath. It's good. Count it. Number 13 at the buzzer. Catherine Neftal of Ipswich hits the shot. And at the one quarter, we've got Ipswich, Manchester 9, Ipswich 5. We'll be back in a few minutes.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
When you walk into either of our branches, you'll experience a local bank feel with big bank returns. We are proud to support many community organizations, nonprofits, and events, both financially and by employees volunteering their time. That's why we support KPN Television, so that with the help of their volunteers, they can deliver valuable community-based news, sports and information about KPN, which is so important to us all.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPN TV. You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
We take pride in our ability to anticipate and adapt to the ever-changing terrain of the commercial printing industry. Since our founding in 1922, the Cricket Press, along with our weekly newspaper, the Manchester Cricket, have long valued the importance of local news and information. That is why we support KPN Television, so they can continue to provide community television programming for the KPN area.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPN TV.
Back after one quarter of play, the Manchester Essex girls lead it 9-5 over the Ipswich Tigers. Kind of a hectic first quarter. So Manchester will inbound it. Ipswich has 17 fouls and Manchester has 4. So the Hornets are on the offense. Shot is up. Good. Number 2, Bridget Kernan. And Manchester has an 11-5 lead early in the second quarter. So Ipswich on the offense now. Get underneath. Nice defense by Manchester. Here come the Hornets. They throw it down floor. And they control it. Get it back up high again. Three-pointer. It's good. Grace Brennan, number four. It's a three for Manchester, but it's 14-5 Manchester. Here, early in the second quarter. So Ipswich on the offense, trying to get something going. They haven't had a basket in a while. Shot is up, no good. Rebound, Pomeroy. And she lays it up and in. Number two for Manchester, Bridget Kernan. And right now, the Hornets are in total control. 16-5. Daly drives to the lane. And the foul is on Grace Brennan of Manchester. So Daly of Ipswich will go to the line. Kelsey Daly. Shot is up. It's good. And Ipswich hasn't had a point in a while. And we got some substitutes taking place here. Pomeroy comes out for Manchester. Brennan comes out for Manchester. Daly for Ipswich at the line. She shoots. It's good. Okay, so it's 16-7. Ipswich with a 9-point lead. Excuse me, Manchester with a 9-point lead. Shot is up and good. Number 23, Caitlin O'Connell for the Hornets. So the Tigers of Ipswich trying to claw their way back in. Shot is up, and oh good, in and out. Rebound, Hornets, number 12, Melanie Carter. Carter with it, throw it up, shot. Carter with another nice strong rebound there. And Carter, and what do we got? Ball went out of bounds. All right, so we got a foul on Ipswich. Kate Pfeiffer's. And that's the eighth team foul for Ipswich, so the Hornets will go to the line the rest of this half. Emily Jacobson is at the line for the Hornets. Throws it up. It's good. It's a one-on-one situation, so she'll get another shot. 19-7, Manchester leads it. Jacobson throws it up, it's good. So it's a 20-7 lead for the Hornets. And here come the Tigers of Ipswich. They swing it around, they get it up high. Daly, three-pointer. Oh, no good, off the rim. And it's Manchester ball. So Bridget Kernan takes it out for Manchester. Caitlin O'Connell dribbles it up the floor. Jacobson with the ball underneath. Shot. It's good. Bridget Kernan. 5 minutes remaining in the first half, and the Hornets are running away with this game. It's 22-7 Manchester. Get a double dribble on Ipswich. So they turn the ball over. Manchester go back on the offense with exactly 5 minutes to go in the first half. Tim Evans on the camera tonight. I'm Phil Nicastro. KPN TV's coverage of Manchester Essex girls basketball. The shot is up, no good. Strong rebound, Manchester. So the Hornets maintain possession. And what do we got? Traveling. So Ipswich catches a break. We have a timeout on the floor. No, wait a minute. Do we? A substitution timeout. So we'll keep it right here. And here come the Tigers of Ipswich. And they trail it big. Hey, Soap, you're out now. Soap. Short is up. No good. Another strong rebound by the Hornets. Sarah Robinson. She brings it up floor. Passes it over to O'Connell. Shot is up. Good. Bridget Kernan again. And now we have a timeout for Ipswich. With the score, the Hornets 24, Ipswich 7. We'll be back in a few minutes.
Daddy, that light's on again. I think we need to go to Extreme Truck and Auto and Cheese Shop.
When this happens to you, there's no need to go to a dealer, whether you're a foreign or a domestic car. We can take care of that right here at Extreme. We have a complete line of Snap-on diagnostics specifically made for all your vehicle needs. Bumper to bumper, foreign or domestic, we can take care of it all here at Extreme. Here at Extreme, we guarantee all of our work for you.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
Here at the Fitness Zone, we are proud to serve the community that we have been a part of for over 18 years. Here you will find a huge selection of equipment, fitness classes, personal trainers, and a juice bar. We are located at 37 Blackburn Center, right next door to Cape Ann TV. Community is the key. That's why we support Cape Ann Television, so they can deliver valuable, local, and community-based news and sports from Cape Ann, which is so important to all of us.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support Cape Ann TV.
Everybody, welcome back. Ipswich calls a timeout. And they will inbound the ball underneath their own hoop. Number 13, Catherine Niftal. Over to Daly. Daly back to Niftal. And Ipswich looking for their first basket in a while. They swing it around, the shot is up. It's no good. Strong rebound, but Ipswich takes control. She lays it up, no good. Ipswich gets the rebound. So the Tigers. And she steps out of bounds. So Daly couldn't handle the pass. And Manchester will go back on the offense again. Caitlin O'Connell brings the ball up floor. Robinson has it. Back to Carter, underneath, nice pass. She missed the shot, number 3, Courtney Hawley, but she got fouled. So Courtney Hawley will go to the line for the Hornets. First shot is no good. 3:16 left, first half. Ipswich, 9 team fouls. Manchester has 5. Courtney Hawley gets another shot. She throws it up. It's good. All right. 25-7. Manchester leads it. And here come the Tigers. So the Tigers are swinging the ball around, trying to get underneath. Daly with it. And 24 second violation. Actually, it's a 30 second violation. This is not the NBA. So Manchester will inbound it. Three-pointer. It's good. Sarah Robinson with a three-pointer. And the Manchester Essex Hornets have a big lead. foul. Grace Brennan on the foul. We got some substitutions. So Ipswich maintains possession after the foul on Manchester. Shot is up, no good. And Manchester gets the rebound. They bring the ball down floor, but they turn it over. So they try that long pass. They couldn't connect on it, and it went out of bounds. So Ipswich will go back on the offense. Trying to somehow generate some offense as Manchester's playing some real tight defense. Get a foul on Sarah Robinson. So Ipswich will now be going to the line in a one-on-one situation because Manchester has now has seven fouls. Tatum Galuski for Ipswich. She makes her first shot, just a freshman. Tatum Galuski. She has another shot coming to her. And she hits it. So it's 28-9. Manchester leads it. And they have the possession of the ball. Three-pointer. It's good. Caitlin O'Connell with a three-pointer. Here come the Tigers, shot, it's good. Number 14 for Ipswich, Sophia Radzum. Hits a two-pointer, what do we have? They're traveling on Ipswich. McLaughlin, Ashley McLaughlin. She traveled, and so Ipswich will go on the offense. We have 1:25 remaining in the first half. Three-pointer, Daly, no good. Rebound, nice strong rebound, and a foul.
White 14, 1, 4, 2.
So McLaughlin, foul on Manchester. Ipswich will go to the line, number 14 for Ipswich, Sophia Radzum. Shot is up. It's good. Sophia, it's another one. No good. Rebound Hornets. So Manchester back on the offense and they turn it over. So we're under a minute now and this which turns it back over. So Caitlin O'Connell with it. Gives it a nice pass in. Lays it up and in. Courtney Hawley. Great passing by the Hornets on that play. Ipswich. They get it down low. No good. Goes out of bounds, so Manchester, with 25 seconds left, will go back on the offense again. Shot clock is off. Pomeroy. So the Hornets get a big lead here. They can take their time on offense here. And we get a foul. Nope. Foul was on Manchester, offensive foul, okay. So Ipswich looking for the last shot. 5 seconds, shot is up, no good. Rebound, shot is up, and no good. And that's the end of the first half with the score of the Manchester Hornets, 33. The Tigers of Ipswich, 12. We'll be back with second half action in a few moments.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community. Underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
At Glover's Floor Covering, for more than 60 years, we have provided our customers with real value in quality carpets, hardwood flooring, laminate flooring, vinyl flooring, and ceramic tile. We're involved in the communities we serve and take great pride in our ability to support Cape Ann Television so that they in turn can deliver valuable community-based programming for Cape Ann.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support Cape Ann TV. Volunteer production opportunities are available in all the towns we serve. Get into local TV. Call the station to find out more.
We are a full-service florist. We deliver to all of Cape Ann and the North Shore. We also provide wedding flowers, funeral flowers, everything from birth to death, basically. My name is Maria Russell, and I own and work at Russell's Florist in Gloucester. We have been in business in Gloucester for 21 years. We were both born and raised here. Our parents were also born and raised here. Our grandparents were born and raised here, so it seemed a good fit for us. I think it's important to support KPN TV because it provides so much for our community. There's so much programming on there, and usually at any given time you turn the TV on, KPN TV, you'll see somebody you know or recognize something or some event or some musician, all kinds of things. I think that KPN TV has so much to offer our community, whether you're in retail, whether you're in the arts, or whether you own a store on Main Street, KPN TV provides so much for Gloucester and Cape Ann. We are a very proud supporter of KPN TV.
To learn more about becoming a Cape Ann TV underwriter, email sponsor at capeanntv.org.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
At Scott Energy, we have built our business one customer at a time with a hands-on, personal approach. In the process, we have gained customers in our communities who have come to appreciate our attention to value and quality service. We truly appreciate your business, and in turn, have made it our policy to give back to the communities that we serve. That's why we support KPN Television, so that they can deliver valuable, community-based news and information about KPN, which is important to all of us.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support Cape Ann TV.
Welcome back. KPN TV's coverage of Manchester Essex girls basketball. And what a good first half the Hornets had. They lead it 33-12. I'm sure Coach Lauren DuBois was extremely pleased at the way her team played in that first half. And they opened up a big lead. Ipswich got themselves into some serious foul trouble early in the game, and Manchester took advantage of it. So here we go. We start the second half. Ipswich will inbound the ball. Number 13, Catherine Neftal. Here comes Daly. Neftal. Ipswich swings it around. Trying to find some offense. Their last 4 points in that first half came off three throws, and we have a turnover. And a foul. No good. All right. Sarah Robinson with the steal. She drove to the lane and got fouled. She will go to the line and shoot two. Tim Evans on the camera tonight. Shot is good by Robinson. She has another shot coming to her. Shot is good. 35-12 Manchester early in the second half. We He's swinging around. And again, they turn it over. Robinson again. Nice passing by Manchester. Oh, she falls down. It's a turnover. And here come the Tigers. Daly, nice pass. But good defense by Manchester. Great defense there. Isabella Pomeroy. Pomeroy. And she gets fouled. Deidre O'Flynn, number 40 for Manchester. For Ipswich. Draws the foul. And that's two quick fouls for Ipswich already. Short is up. Robinson, no good. And Ipswich with the rebound. O'Flynn. Short is up. No good. Short is up. No good. Ipswich getting some rebounds, but they can't score. Shot is up, three-pointer, no good. Rebound, Ipswich. We got a foul on Manchester. Melanie Carter. And it's a non-shooting foul. So Ipswich will inbound it underneath the basket. They get it up high, and they maintain possession. Daly with it. Shot is up. No good. Rebound. Here comes Manchester. Pomeroy underneath. She misses the shot, but she gets fouled. Chloe Rogers gets the foul. Number 32, Pomeroy. Pomeroy from Manchester hits the first free throw. The foul was on Daly. Pomeroy hits the second free throw. So Manchester has extended their lead to 37-12. About halfway through the third quarter. Ipswich, shot is up, no good. Rebound, Manchester. But the ball goes out of bounds off number 12, Melanie Carter. So Ipswich will maintain possession. Daly will inbound it for Ipswich. They get it in, shot, three-pointer, no good. And ball goes out of bounds off of Manchester again. Right now, the Tigers of Ipswich cannot hit a basket. Shot is up. No good. Rebound Manchester. Sarah Robinson. Here come the Hornets. Good passing. Nice passing. Oh, stolen by Daly, but she steps out of bounds. Manchester will maintain possession. Bridget Kernan will throw it in. Courtney Hawley has possession right now. And foul again on Daly of Ipswich. The substitution buzzer. Tatum Galuski, number 2, comes in the game for Ipswich. But Manchester on the offense. Underneath, nice play. Isabella Pomeroy lays it up and in with a great pass. From Sarah Robinson. Beautiful. The Tigers on some offense. Throw it up, no good. Again, Manchester with the rebound. Here comes Robinson, and she's fouled. Oh, no, she travels. Okay. So there's no foul on that play. Good traveling on Robinson. Manchester making some subs. They got a big lead, 39-12. 4.5 minutes left, third quarter. Here comes Ipswich. They haven't hit a basket in a long time, other than some free throws. And again, a turnover of Robinson. She lays it up, and no good, and she gets fouled. Chloe Rogers commits the foul for Ipswich, and they already have five this half. So Robinson, Sarah Robinson shoots. She hits. It's 40-12. Manchester Essex leads it. And she hits. 41-12. Shot is up. No good. Rebound Manchester. Number 20, Emily Jacobson. Just a freshman. Three-pointer, no good. And possession arrow. Oh, foul, we got a foul on Grace Brennan of Manchester. Okay, so it'll be Ipswich ball. Non-shooting foul. And Ipswich with some wholesale substitutions. And here come the Tigers. Get it underneath. And jump ball. Good defense by Pomeroy, number 10. And number 33 comes in for Manchester. I don't have her on my list. But the Hornets are on the offense. Number 22 with the foul, Cassidy King for Ipswich. And Ipswich already has 16 fouls in this half. And Manchester has possession. And turnover. Good play by number two for Ipswich. She lays it up. No good. Rebound. No good. And jump. Possession arrow Ipswich. Three-pointer from Ipswich, shot is up, no good. Lays it up, no good. And the Tigers just can't hit a basket. They've had some opportunities, they just can't. Shot is up, good. Number 33 for Manchester. She's not on my roster. Glass. Now, okay, number 33, Ava Glass from Manchester is in the game. Foul again on number two, Tatum Galuski of Ipswich. Shot's no good. Number four, Grace Brennan is at the line for the Hornets. Shot is up. No good. Rebound Tigers. So Ipswich swinging the ball around at the perimeter. And traveling. Manchester ball. And number 44 for Manchester comes in the game, Bridget Twombly. Caitlin O'Connell, number 23. Passes it over to Sarah Robinson. Over to Jacobson. And foul on Ipswich, number 13, Catherine Neftal. A Noftal. That's what they're telling me now. Catherine Noftal. Eva Glass at the line. Shot. Good. No, that's Bridget Twombly at the line. I'm sorry. Twombly. Shot. No good. Rebound. Ipswich. So 1.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter. And Ipswich trying desperately to get some offense going. They've had some opportunities. It just won't go in the net for them. And they turn it over. Emily Jacobson, number 23. No, excuse me, Catherine O'Connell from Manchester. They pass it underneath. Shot, three-pointer, no good. Rebound, Manchester. O'Connell. She drives the lane. She loses possession. And Sarah Robinson throws it in. We're under a minute left in the third quarter. Manchester shot is up. No good. And here come the Hornets. Caitlin O'Connell. Over to Robinson. Back over to O'Connell. What a nice move. She throws it up. Oh, no good. Rebound. No good by Glass. Rebound, Robinson. No good. Seven seconds left. The foul was on Emily Jacobson of Manchester. With 5 seconds left in the third quarter. Manchester, Ipswich looking for that last shot. Throws it up. No good. All right, at the end of three quarters, the score of the Manchester Hornets, 46. The Ipswich Tigers, 12. We'll be back in a few minutes.
You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
At Ben's Wallpaper and Paint, you will experience a level of service you thought no longer existed. We're proud to deliver the kind of specialized attention that you thought no longer existed and simply won't find in larger chain stores. Whether from our full line of Benjamin Moore paint or custom window treatments, you will find what you need at Ben's Wallpaper and Paint at 6 Railroad Avenue here in Gloucester. Community is the key. That's why we support KPN Television, so they can deliver valuable, local, community-based news, sports, and information about KPN, which is so important to all of us.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support KPN TV. You're watching local programming created by volunteers in your community, underwritten with the generous support of local businesses.
Cape Ann Auto Body and Service Center has served Cape Ann families since 1955. We learned long ago that the best way to keep our customers is to provide skilled and friendly services at reasonable prices. Unlike large or chain repair businesses, each of our customers is a very important part of our business.
Personal is what makes Cape Ann Television so valuable to our community. That's why we support Cape Ann Television, so they can deliver valuable community-based news, sports, and information about Cape Ann, which is so important to us all.
Join, volunteer, support local programming for and about Essex, Gloucester, Manchester, and Rockport. Support Cape Ann TV.
right, everybody, welcome back. Tim Evans on the camera tonight. I'm Phil Nicastro. This is KPN TV's coverage of Manchester Essex girls basketball, and the Hornets have a huge 46-12 lead as we enter the fourth quarter. And Coach Lauren DuBois, she has to be pleased the way her team is playing tonight. Shot is no good. And out of bounds off of Manchester, so Ipswich will regain control. Ipswich has 18 fouls this half. Manchester only has three. And Eva Glass, nice defense, number 33. Get underneath the Eva Glass. She brings it back out, back up high again. They swing it around, three-pointer, no good. Good rebound. Number 20, Emily Jacobson. Just a freshman. Fouls on number 15 for Ipswich. Kate Pfeiffer's. Emily Jacobson will go to the line for the Hornets. She'll shoot two. She nails it. Shot is good. So Jacobson nails both foul shots. Ipswich on the offense. And again, they turn it over. Caitlin O'Connell. And this Manchester team, a couple of young freshmen in there. Caitlin O'Connell, Emily Jacobson, playing very well. And you got Grace Brennan, Isabella Pomeroy, two sophomores that play a lot. Looking good. Shot was missed. Here come the Tigers. Shot is up for Ipswich, no good. Grace Brennan comes back in. And Caitlin O'Connell comes out. Good job by Caitlin tonight. Shot is up, no good. Rebound Manchester. Bridget Twombly out there, number 44. Shot is up, no good. Rebound Ipswich, and here come the Tigers. And turnover by Ipswich. Grace Brennan with the ball. Sarah Robinson over to Eva Glass. Shot is up, no good. Eva Glass lays it up and in. No, excuse me. Bridget Twombly, number 44. And Ipswich turns it over. Five minutes, 35 seconds remaining in the game. The score is 50-12. Shot is up. It's good. Number four, Grace Brennan. So Ipswich trying to find something. Shot clock's down to five. But it's a turnover. And here come the Hornets again. Sarah Robinson, she pulls it back and resets the offense. Eva Glass underneath. Shot is up. No good. That was Robinson on the miss. So, Ipswich having a hard time tonight. Shot is blocked. Twombly with a nice defense. Eva Glass with nice defense, but she's getting fouled. So number 33, Eva Glass, gets a foul. And Ipswich will go to the line. She was in the act of shooting. Number 40, Deidre O'Flynn. Shot is up. It's good. I think the last 8 points Ipswich has hit all have come from the foul line. I don't think they've hit a field goal since halfway through the second quarter. Shot is up. There's one. Number 22, Cassidy King, hits a two-point shot for the Ipswich Tigers. Eva Glass. It drives to the lane. Number 11 out there for Manchester. I don't have her in my roster either. So the coach of Manchester, she's putting some of her JVs into the game. I don't blame her. And this Manchester girls team, boy, I tell you, they're looking pretty good. Twombly, no good. Rebound, Ipswich. Just drives the lane, blocked, Eva Glass. And be Ipswich ball. Sophia Radzim will, the two referees are talking. Shot is up for Ipswich, no good. Twombly the rebound. Number 15 is in the game for Manchester. I don't have her name either. Turnover. And there's a foul on Manchester, number 15. So Manchester coach Lauren DuBois, she's cleaning out her bench. Shot is up is good. Number two for Ipswich, Tatum Galuski. Shot is missed. And Galuski goes right in there, jump ball. Possession arrow, Manchester. Eva Glass, number 33. Twombly, 5 seconds left on the shot clock. And shot clock violation, Manchester. 2:14 left in the game. Tim Evans doing a great job on the camera tonight. KPN TV's coverage of Manchester Essex girls basketball. The Hornets have a huge lead. With just a couple of minutes left in the game. Shot is up, good. Number 14 for Ipswich, Sophia Radzim. Makes it 52-18. And we're under 2 minutes now. Shot is up, no good. And Ipswich gets the rebound. So the Manchester Hornets girls team will go to 2-0 in the season. They beat Georgetown to open the season. And here with an impressive victory against Ipswich. Turnover. Ipswich has it. Shot is up, no good. Rebound. And what do we got? Jump ball. Possession arrow, Ipswich. 107 left in the game. Pass inbounds. Got a foul. Number 33, Eva Glass of Manchester. And she is one tall girl. It's hard to penetrate the lane when Eva's in there. Shot is up. No good. And Cyphers, oh, Fipers, for Ipswich hits her second shot. And we approach 1 minute left in the game. 52-19, Manchester with a huge lead. And an impressive performance here tonight. Shot is up and good. And with under a minute. Shot is up for Ipswich. Shot is no good. Rebound. Hornets. Half a minute remaining. Outstanding performance tonight by the Manchester Lady Hornets. Shot is up. No good. Rebound. And it goes out of bounds. Manchester ball. 11 and a half seconds left in the game. Shot is up. No good. And we wind it down. 5 seconds. Here comes Ipswich looking for the last shot. She throws it up. No good. And that's the end of the ball game. We'll show you the handshake. The final score. The Hornets of Manchester, 55. The Tigers of Ipswich, 19. For my cameraman, Tim Evans. Thank you, Tim. I'm Phil DeCastro, and this has been KPN TV's coverage of Manchester Essex girls basketball. Until next time, folks, good night, everybody.